So I want to tell you a story. Just real quick. So my three-year-old, her name is Glory. And she's kind of like a mini-me. I mean, she has brown skin, but she's like a mini-me. And she kind of just does a lot of things that I like to do. And if I'm in the house, she's always like right on my heels, following me around. And the other morning, we were at a conference doing worship, and I wake up, and Glory's like 6 inches from my face. And she's foaming at the mouth. She was brushing her teeth, which means she's foaming at the mouth and running down. And there's like toothpaste dripping on my pillow, and on my sheets. She's like, "You awake, Dad?" I was like, "I am now." So she runs in the bathroom, cleans off her face, and oftentimes in the morning, this is her routine, she'll come in and she climbs up over me. And she finds like that spot in my back that's kind of like the warm spot in the bed, and she just like curls up and waits. Just like waits for me to wake up so she can follow me downstairs and eat all my breakfast. She does this thing where she talks in third person. So I hear her behind me as I'm trying to like maybe go back to sleep for another little snooze. She says, "She just gonna wait right here. She just gonna be patient." We talk a lot about patience because she doesn't like to be patient. She's gonna be patient. And then she starts talking as if she's me. She talks for me and she goes, "I'm gonna get up real soon. Then I'm gonna take you to the playground." So she's planning out our morning activities together. And as I was laying there, I realized that the night before I'd eaten Waffle House really late at night, which always seems like a good idea late at night, right? It's like everything's a good idea. And I realized that morning that my stomach was saying it wasn't such a good idea. And Glory's right behind me, like right. And so I might have just, you know, released a little pressure on the system. And she pops up over me like a meerkat. She goes, "What'd you do?" And I pretended to be asleep, and she goes, "Daddy Rudy Tootie." And you know what? She just curled right back down and waited some more. She's like, "She's just gonna sit here. She's gonna wait." And what I realized in that moment was she just wanted to be near me, even in my Waffle House morning fog. She wanted to be near me. And here's why I tell you this story, because I believe that our God wants us to be so near to Him, to be in His presence. He wants us. You and I, our hearts, and our lives. And don't get so caught up in the work that you lose His presence, because it's real easy to do. Trust me, it's real easy to get so caught up in what you do for Him that you lose just being in His presence. And so as we push forward in this Friday together, let's be in His presence. Maybe like we've never been before. And He will continue to change us and move us to what He has for us. Let's worship.
In the arms of the Father, there is love.
Through the dark, through the night.
out of that nearness, out of that intimacy with our Father, He will send us. And that's where the word comes from. When we stand in His presence and we call Him our friend and our Savior and our Lord, our Shepherd, then the word flows out of us. Amen.
Thank you. made.